Thank you very much. Normally this could have been a great ending to the conference, but since we are in the high holidays, the Jewish holidays, I wanted to share with you the Kol Nidre. Now I know it's a church, I know it's a Catholic church. In fact, that was one of my dreams always, to play Kol Nidre in a church, so here it is. But it's more so because of the time of year. This is the end of the Jewish year calendar. And we in the Jewish religion, we have a day in our calendar to basically acknowledge all the mistakes we did during the year and to ask for forgiveness. Now, you don't have to be Jewish to make bad things, you know that. But asking for forgiveness is something we all need to learn how to do and how to accept that we did maybe bad things. So Yom Kippur is that day, and that happens next Sunday. Yom Kippur is the holiest prayer in the Jewish religion, and Max Bruch, the composer of this piece, was not Jewish. But he was invited by a friend of his in Liverpool in England, the end of the 19th century, to witness the Kol Nidre. I don't know about you, but I know that I invited some of my friends for the high holidays. Some of them are not Jewish, and they always get excited by this event and the food before and after. So Bruch did the same thing. He came to the Kol Nidre prayer. He heard the cantor, the singer of the prayer, and he was blown away by it. He went back home and he wrote down note by note the prayer. In this arrangement, I will be the cantor, and Martin will be you, the congregation. What you have to understand about the old tradition of Jewish synagogue is that women and men are separated. So when you hear the choir singing, when it's low, it will be the men. When it's high, it will be the women, separate parts of the synagogue. The cantor and the rabbi, not like in a church where they stand there and face you, the cantor and the rabbi are facing the Bible, which is back there, the Torah. Not only that their back is to you, they're covered with what we call talit. It's a big piece of cloth that covers them from here, from birth, and they're conversing only with God. So when I sing on the cello the prayer, you have to imagine me covered and with my back to you. The prayer itself will appear four times. The first time, I will sing it like I do every year, and you will reply to it like you do every year, very casually, like whatever, you know. Sometimes we go to synagogue or to church, and we do the things we have to do. We stand up and say amen, we look down, we might even check our emails, say hello to our friends. But this time, it will happen four times, and by the fourth time, I, the little man asking for forgiveness, and you, my friends and family, will understand that this year, it's different, and I might not make it this time. So, let Martin play the first time where you are humming the response to the prayer. It will be just casual. Something is happening. We actually have to pay attention and to feel something. Our friend or family is in trouble. Do you hear the harmony? Now the fourth time, there's no harmony. No jokes anymore. There's the hell and it's fire. So the fire of hell, me standing there pleading for forgiveness, that's what you will hear under the same Kol Nidre. Azkaban, the jail where your soul goes to jail, basically. So you have the guards of Azkaban that come to you and take your soul. That's exactly what happened in this prayer. You will hear the piano playing, the Death Eaters coming to take my soul before I plead for forgiveness. Sound like this. And basically after it, like standing in front of a jury, I will plead with shouting, with running, with whispering, you name it, I'll do it on the cello, asking for forgiveness. Then you will hear the fire of hell and the Connie Drake for the last time. After that, the verdict will come. And that's the second part of the piece. And of course, I'm not going to tell you what is happening. You'll have to decide if I made it to heaven or not.